I'd like to call to order the Westmont Village Board meeting of June 25th, 2015 at 6 o'clock p.m. Clerk Simsky, roll call, please.
Mayor Gunther?
Here.
The clerk's here. Trustee Addington is absent tonight. Trustee Barry?
Here.
Trustee Barker?
Here.
Trustee Johannik Guzzo?
Here.
Trustee Little?
Here.
And Trustee Nero is absent tonight.
Okay, would everybody please rise and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I forgot to announce her.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I should announce that the manager, May, is here.
Here.
Attorney Zimanek is here. And Finance Director Parker is here.
Okay, they're all in attendance, and I'd like to good evening and welcome everybody to today's meeting. We start off with open forum. I do have one request for open forum, and that's from Gwendolyn Westland. She's here to talk about recycled life and Westmont local heroes, blood drive. So come up to the podium and give us the information.
Hello, my name is Gwendolyn Westland, and I run an organization called Recycled Life. A lot of you know me. I'm hosting a blood drive with Westmont Local Heroes on August 21st with LifeSource. It's from 1 to 7 p.m. at the Westmont Park District. I am inviting Mr. Mayor. I am inviting the Board of Directors here with the Village. I'm inviting the Chief of Police, Tom Mulhern, Chief of Fire Department, Chief Weiss, and their teams. Also, I'll be inviting nurses and any medical staff from Sugar Creek and Burgess Square. Anyone from School District 201 who would like to participate, we'd love to have anybody from our amazing school district in Westmont and teachers. So really focusing on people who do what they do to serve others, I think is the goal here, and getting as much participation from the people who live here as possible. We have a record of 72 units of blood as the biggest blood drive in Westmont, and I'd like to surpass that with at least 100 units. It takes quite a bit to save lives. So just really quickly, my life took 30 units of blood, which in Westmont, we usually have an average of 15 units per blood drive. So if you think about that, plus the fact that you need a specific kind of blood to save your life, it's kind of an awe, you know, kind of piece of information to know that 30 units needed to save my life. That's a lot. And granted, my circumstance was extreme with the heart transplant and open heart surgeries, but on average, 15 is not a huge number. So I just think we can really set some new records with this event and save a lot of lives. So
good.
Just hoping
and again,
everybody
that's
can
at
come.
The community center is 75 East Richmond.
Oh, thank you. Yes. And it'll be in the gym.
Okay.
And we're actually looking at having participants from the community as well. So it's developing, and we'll get flyers out with more information as soon as possible.
Good.
Okay.
Again,
thank you so much.
Thank you. Before I close open forum, is there anybody who didn't get a chance to fill out a form would like to? If not, then I'll close open forum and move on to board reports. And the first one is the mayor's report. And at this time, I'd like to call Larry McIntyre to the podium to talk about the Tyco event update that's coming to our town in July. And I think we've got representatives here from that organization.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. As we mentioned at the last board meeting, we've been working a lot with our Tyco group here in town, the Taiwanese Cultural Center, and we have an event coming up. It's going to be Monday, July 20th, so we understand that a lot of people will be working and they won't be able to attend, but that'll be all right because it's a folk sports troupe, and part of the goal is to make sure that we have a lot of kids involved. The people who will actually be performing are going to be youths, and they're from Taiwan. They're doing a North American tour, and when they stop in Chicago, they're going to stop by Westmont on that Monday, July 20th. So in the morning, about 10 a.m., there's going to be a hands-on demonstration at the Park District Community Center. That address is 75 East Richmond. It's going to be free to the public, by the way. And these athletes are going to teach kids, anyone who in attendance, how to do the different sports that that they're going to be presenting later in the day. And then they're going to take a break, come back at 1:30, and then they'll do a full performance. That's going to be about a 90-minute performance in which they will do a full presentation of their folk sports. And so if people are familiar with hacky sack or something like that, a lot of balancing, a lot of interesting sports, folk sports from Taiwan that really there's nothing to compare it to here in the United States. There's another thing that they do where they have a long rope, and then they balance balls on the rope, and then they juggle those, and it's very interesting. You can actually look at it online via YouTube. You can just search Taiwanese folk sports, and you'll see examples of that. But anyway, that's going to be July 20th at the community center.
And we have representatives. Would they like to say anything?
I'm not sure. I don't think so. Not.
Oh, okay. Well, good. Well, I'm. Thank you. All right, Mom. I'll ask Chief Mulhern come to the podium. This is really kind of a kind of heartwarming story that we have one of our local heroes here that he wants to talk about.
Thank you, Mayor. If I could have one of our very special residents come and join me up here, and that is Aaron Compton, who's coming here now. Aaron is a resident in Westmont, and her dad is here with her tonight, Greg Compton, and her mom, Diane. They had mentioned to me that Aaron won, or was selected, to be, and this is very hard for me to say, the pre-teen queen for the Miss Amazing contest.
Hold this. Hey, Tom, I'm going to ask you to go restart that.
I'm trying
over
to stand next to Aaron.
There
okay.
You go.
You stay there, I'll stay here.
I know you're nervous in front of a beauty queen.
I am. As I'll start all over, Aaron was selected as the Illinois pre-teen queen for the Miss Amazing contest. And not only that, she's also wearing her gold medal that she won for Special Olympics.
Nice.
And here's another one. Dad tested me today in rhythmic gymnastics. Try to say all those real quick. Downstate. And then I wanted to let our residents and the board know, as we always do, we try to acknowledge the accomplishments of the youth and all of our residents. And I thought Erin needed to be recognized for bringing not only her Special Olympics, but also her title to Westmont. How proud is it? Erin will be going in July to California to represent Illinois and Westmont, and more importantly, herself, in the national Miss Amazing contest. And the mission of Miss Amazing is to provide opportunities for girls and women with disabilities to build self-confidence throughout the skills learned in pageantry in a supporting environment. And also out in California is the National Special Olympics Conference or competition. And Erin will be volunteering there. She won't be participating this year in the hopes that next year she can participate in the Special Olympics next year nationally. But this year she's going to volunteer. And then if Dad could come over, and what is she stopped, you guys are making one stop in Utah, I believe.
Yes, we are.
And if you want to tell us about that, and then maybe any more, think about more about Aaron. And oh, one thing I will say, and then I'll be quiet, was that Aaron last Thursday night, I was honored to have her as my guest, as our grand parade marshal in our lights and siren parade last Thursday night for the street fair. And she was, both of us got tired arms from waving so much. So, and I'll let Dad Greg talk a little bit about what's going to happen when you guys go to Utah.
Okay, thank you, Chief. Good evening, everybody, and thank you. Well, Erin is amazing, and I'm just proud to be her father. But the thing is, she is heading out to Utah. She is filming another special needs video for kids with disabilities in the Signing Time series. This will be the third time that she'll perform in one of their videos, and it's actually filming for her on July the 20th in Salt Lake City. So since we're already heading out west, and now that she was selected to be the Miss Team, Miss Amazing Queen, we have to go to LA for her to compete for the national thing. And the only reason Erin was selected is she has been ill for the last 5 months, and the nurses from Lori's Children's Hospital recommended that she be a part of this particular organization and go out and try her luck. And lo and behold, the doctors cleared her for the opportunity, and she won. And now we are on our way, pageant dad. Thank you very much, guys, for all of your assistance and help. And we're just trying to help the organization, Miss Amazing, get some notoriety. And obviously, if anybody's interested in making a donation to sit there and help Miss Amazing, I'll give the chief the website, and we can put it on online, and anything that they could do that would help. It's a fantastic organization that sits there and helps kids, young adults, and women up to about age 50 with disabilities have a wonderful night out, and a lot of fun, some dancing, and so on and so forth. Thank you guys for your time.
Congratulations.
The only thing we ask is that when you come back from California, you let us know how she did.
Absolutely.
And pictures, and so we know. And I was thinking, okay, are they flying? Or they're driving. So it'd be like National Lampoon's American Vacation. Nothing but best wishes. Thank you, Mayor.
All right, thanks, Chief. Next item for me is 4th of July fireworks at Ty Warner Park, sponsored by the Westmont Auto Mile. It's a joint effort between the Park District and the Village. The fireworks, again, starts at 9:30. There's activities at 4 on to the rest of the evening for people of all ages. There'll be food, entertainment, music. And the one other thing I could say in today's Trib Local, you didn't see Westmont, which is good and bad. The good is we're pretty full as it is now, but the bad is people might think we're not having it. But we are having it Saturday night, the 4th, starting at 9:30. Our concerts in the park are on Wednesday evenings, the four evenings from July 15th to August the 5th, 7 p.m. start. Two will be at Veterans Memorial and two at Ty Warner. Visit the website for more information. That's westmontparks.org. And our Taste of Westmont will be after the 4th, the following week from the 9th through the 12th, on downtown Westmont, we'll be having our annual Taste of Westmont, which has grown every year, and everybody looks forward to attending. And I don't know if Larry has any additional information for that, or that's all right, that's good enough. Then I'd like to call up Chief Weiss, and I understand he has a special award.
I do, Mayor, thank you very much. Before I do that, I just wanted to remind everybody of our kids' safety camps that we're having right now. We just finished our June one with 28 participants. Our July class is July 16th and 17th, and I believe the dates for August is the 6th and 7th. We still have openings in both of those classes. Contact the fire department if you're interested, and we can get you an application. Now, Mayor, I want to let you and the board know that this week at McCormick Place in Chicago is the International Building and Fire Code Conference, and Director Kaufman went there for 2 days. And while he was there, he was surprised to find out that they called him up to present him the Village of Westmont certificate. And this is from the Illinois Fire Inspectors, the Illinois Fire Chiefs, the Illinois Fire Sprinkler Association, the National Fire Sprinkler Association, the Northern Illinois Fire Sprinkler Advisory Board. They do hereby recognize the Village of Westmont, Mayor Gunther, Village Trustee Guzzo, Barker, Addington, Nero, Leto, and Barry, myself, and the Village Clerk, Simpsky, for following FEMA's American Burning Report guidelines for protecting the citizens, and FEMA's Firefighter Life Safety Summit recommendations for the protection of the firefighters by adopting the new fire codes and the residential fire sprinkler codes for single-family homes, given on this 22nd day of June 2015. So I want to present this to you.
I'll just stay back. Oh, I need to come around. Huh, Larry? Mm-hmm. All right.
One last thing. I had the honor to be called at 3 in the morning the other morning and asked to be a task force team leader to take three task force and 75 firefighter paramedics and technical rescue specialists to Coast City where the tornadoes went through. We organized at Darren Woodridge Fire Station at 5:30 in the morning, and we went down I-55 all the way to Coast City. We were there about 7:30 in the morning. Our task and job was to relieve firefighter, paramedics, and technical rescue guys that worked all night doing secondary searches in all the collapsed houses, checking for animals, checking for residents, people that were still inside the collapsed houses. I ended up being the team leader of 75 people. We had three separate task force. We went out into the field in two subdivisions that were hit the worst. And you know, what great devastation that tornadoes do. When they say they're war zones, they are war zones. It's there's this stuff all over. You can't imagine the things that you do see. So it was an honor to do that. And we worked all day. We were relieved about 3 in the afternoon to go in the rehab, get some food, some water. We went back out for another hour. We were sent home at 7 o'clock at night because we were relieved by another task force. The Coast City Fire Chief, I know, very, very personal person, you know, good friend and stuff, and he lost his house and his deputy chief lost his house. So this Saturday, a bunch of fire chiefs, I organized a bunch of fire chiefs and other fire officers. We're going down Saturday morning to help them try to do something with their homes and to help with their firehouse, because they're brand new firehouse of 2 years old. The firemen were trapped in it when the antenna came down and caved in the roof. They had a fire on the roof. They weren't able to go out and help any of their residents or anybody, or even get their apparatus out of their firehouse. So we're going there over the weekend to help them try to organize things, help them with put their firehouse back together. They won't be able to operate in it for probably several months. There's a lot of structural damage. But it was an honor to do that and to lead the people that we did down there. And it was a team effort. And they still need a lot of help. I know they're organizing volunteers, any residents that want to come. But it's an organized thing. You can go on their village website, and you can call the phone numbers to sign up to come down and volunteer to go help clean up the debris, to clean up the areas, things like that. I know they're also accepting clothes, food, and water at the United Methodist Church in Coast City, and they're organizing that. There's other numbers that you can go on the Coast City website that have those numbers. So that was about it, and was honored to do that, and our hearts go out to all them down there.
Good. Thank you, Chief. And that's a good indication of how all the communities in this state bond together to help each other. And that's all I have. I'll move on to Clerk Simsky.
I just want to remind everybody that our next Public Information Committee meeting will be August 20th. They are doing the street fair tonight, so if you're watching TV and wondering about it, it's going on. So go on out there and enjoy. And please come out the 4th of July. There is not a better show in Illinois than Mayor Gunther manages to put together every year for the Village of Westmont. He doesn't take much credit, but if we didn't have him doing this for years, we would not have the class act we have that goes on at Ty Warner Park. It's absolutely phenomenal. And thank you, Mayor, for
thank
all
you.
Your hard work.
All right, Attorney Zeminek.
Thanks, Mayor. I would like to request an executive session on two topics. The first is the purchase of real estate by the village for public use. The second is setting the sales price for real estate owned by the village. Short, right?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll have that on executive session.
Thanks, that's all I have.
Manager May.
Thank you. First, I wanted to remind everyone that village offices will be closed on Friday, July 3rd, in observance of Independence Day. And also, with Trustee Addington absent, would normally report on the Economic Development Committee, but there is no agenda for the one in July, so the next EDC meeting will occur in August, on August 5th. And normally, I like to try and do an update on the state of the state and where they're at with that process, but everyone's very well familiar with that. It seems like nothing's happening. I will say that at the last DuPage Mayors and Managers business meeting we had, we were visited by Senator Oberweis, who came in and kind of reported on one perspective, but the one thing I did get out of it is that, you know, not only are they not going to meet their July 1 deadline nor their July 15th deadline, that what they're hoping is that everything's resolved by August 10th. And the significance of that is that for the Chicago Public School System, that if they don't have their disbursement or their budget by August 11th, they're not allowed to open, for the school year. So that is the biggest target that we know today. How that affects us, we already know we have a budget that's in place that has many pieces that are, I'll just say, on hold or that we're not accessing until we know. But until, there is a budget where there's a threat of a reduced LGDF, we're still, getting it currently. So we're further along in the fiscal year and, talking it over with finance and, a little bit with the mayor, is that we're probably going to suggest in July that we implement the cost of living adjustment for staff that would be effective then, but still none of the components that would have been equated to, or if we chose to implement anything that we've learned from the compensation study, that portion, well, one, it's still being evaluated, and there's still pieces to debug, but that will not happen right away, and that'll be saved for a different portion after we know exactly what the ramifications are of the state. But the cost of living adjustment, we know we can accommodate that for the rest of the year. So I just wanted you to know that those are kind of our deadlines. So maybe July, early July for the COLA, and September or later for, if at all, for the other adjustment.
That was approved in our budget workshop process and included in the budget. So.
Okay, and that was all I had. Okay. Thank you.
So Manager May, did it change yesterday? Did the governor, did he not secure funding yesterday for the Chicago Public Schools?
Well, I didn't hear that. All I heard was that he vetoed like 19 bills this morning. So I have not seen any news regarding the Chicago Public Schools. Hopefully, that was taken into account. That would be good news. But the way it was put, to us by others, that neither Speaker Madigan nor the governor intend to blink, before August 10th.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll move on to trustees. Trustee Guzzo.
Just a few things. Our next Finance Committee meeting will be here July 9th at 4 p.m., so I hope everyone can attend. I want to thank everyone involved with Squad Car Night Thursday night. It was phenomenal. The turnout was amazing. It was nice to see old friends, new friends, and so just thank you to everyone involved in that. It was a great, great time. And I just want to wish everyone a safe and enjoyable holiday. 4th of July is next week, and hope to see everybody at the park. So enjoy. And that's all I have.
Thank you. Trustee Barker.
Just one item. Last night we had a Westmont First meeting, and the conversation, a lot of it was around having a presence at the Taste of Westmont. Westmont First is an organization of a broad spectrum of the community, but open to all the businesses and all the residents. And since we have more people in the audience tonight, it actually has three components to it. One is local charity, and we support local charity. The other one is shopping locally, which helps our community and helps our businesses. And the third one is volunteering. So if you have extra time and you can volunteer for Westmont special events or anywhere in your community, the park district, there's hundreds of opportunities Westmont First urges all the residents to do that. Thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Barry.
I have a couple things. First and foremost, I'd like to thank Chief Weiss and all the volunteers for representing us at Coal City down there. We know how important that is, so thank you. Our next Public Works Committee will be before the next board meeting, which is July 9th. So we invite the public is welcome. If you have Public Works concerns, that's a great place to bring them up. The Environmental Improvement Commission will meet the first Monday in August. I believe that will be the next meeting for them, and those are always subject to change. I did have a sad note. I wanted to wish my deepest sympathy to the Curry family. Brian has lost his long battle with cancer and lifelong resident, and him and his family are residents, or we're residents here, and so our deepest sympathy to them. And that's all I have.
Thank you. Trustee Little.
Thank you, Mayor. Our administration committee meeting will be July 23rd. Anybody wants to come out to that one, you're certainly welcome. And then the Taste of Westmont is just a couple weeks away, and I just want to encourage everyone that the Special Events Corporation definitely needs a lot of volunteers to come out and help us put this together. And if you want to talk to somebody in the office, I encourage you to call Christina at the Special Events Office at 630-829-9378 and volunteer to make this the best one yet. Thank you.
Thank you. Moving on to the agenda, items removed from the consent agenda. Are there any items that any of the trustees want removed from the consent agenda? Seeing none, I'd ask Manager May to read the consent agenda.
Thank you, Mayor. Tonight, first on the consent agenda are Village Board minutes. Board to consider approving the minutes of the Village Board meeting held June 11th, 2015. Next is Finance Ordinance Number 4. And the aggregate amount of $2,081,931.38. Next is the May financial report. Board to consider a motion to accept the financial report submitted for the month of May 2015. Next are purchase orders. First purchase order is Baker Tilly Birchow Kraus in the amount of $25,800, reference to the audit services for fiscal year 15. Next purchase order is to Dumeg, $18,720, and this covers our annual membership contribution. Westmont Chamber of Commerce is the next purchase order, $16,376 for the Economic Development Partnership Program. Next purchase order, Don Morris Architect, $6,840.04. They provide our portion of our building permit review and inspection services, and this is represents the month of May 2015. Next purchase order is Davy Tree for $6,000 for honey locust treatment. I wanted to describe this one a little bit in that the this is for treatment throughout the Oakwood subdivision. Every year we have small infestations that we can take care of, and we have nominal dollar amounts in the budget to take care of it. And actually, previously, we used to have a lot of money in the budget, and we weren't needing it or accessing it, so we've reduced it each year. We have a budgeted amount of $1,000 for this treatment, but there's about 200 tree issue up in Oakwood that we want to get aggressive with the worst of them. So this purchase order, whereas it's unbudgeted for that particular line item, it is a budgeted amount for forestry services, but not for this particular service. So this purchase order is in the amount of $6,000 for the honey locust treatment. Next purchase order is Seco Consultants. This is $7,554. This is for the inspection services, in particular the laboratory work for the street resurfacing project. In here it's listed as the fall street resurfacing, but to us we just know that as the second one we were project for the year, even though that will be getting underway soon. The next purchase order, actually the next two purchase orders, are for Central Blacktop. The reason there's two purchase orders is that the financial software does not accept values of $1 million or more. So the first purchase order is $999,999. Second purchase order is for $28,559.59, and this is for the actual construction services for the motor fuel tax street resurfacing project. That brings the total of purchase orders to $1,109,848.63, and therefore the total of purchase orders and finance ordinance number four. The total is $3,191,780.01. That's it.
Do I have a motion to approve as read?
Motion to approve, Barry.
Second, Guzzo.
Motion been made and seconded on the question. Anybody have a question? Anybody in the audience have a question? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Moving on, we do not have any unfinished business. Before we get to new business, I didn't know with Trustee Addington gone, I didn't know if Larry Forsberg, did you have anything you want to talk about, economic development?
I did have a question.
Yes.
I noticed that there was a lot of trees cleared on 63rd Street. Is there something going on there that we should be aware of?
That is not the honey locust problem.
That's not the honey locust problem.
That is, in fact, the clearing that started for the Mariano's project, so that it's roughly 9.5-acre parcel. They completed the clearing. There's a very impressive mulch pile out in the middle of that parcel. But yeah, we're excited to see them, break ground and.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Thank you.
If anything, it's to avoid.
Now I know what's going on. I felt a little out of the loop.
We'll move on to new business. Westmont Park District 4th of July celebration. Board to consider an ordinance permitting the following in regards to the 2015 Independence Day celebration at Time Warner Park. 1, an amplified sound permit request. 2, a 4th of July community event traffic plan using various one-way and street closures around Time Warner Park from 6 a.m. to 10:30 p.m. or until the public has dispersed after the fireworks presentation. And 3, a special event liquor license fee waiver for the Westmont Park District. And I've got Chief Mulhern, he's out there. So with this event, I'll read it. It is sponsored by the Westmont Auto Mile, and it is run in conjunction with the Park District being the lead organization, and the village kind of co-sponsored this with their manpower. The Class 11 special event liquor license fee is $100. All requests are the same as 2004. And again, staff recommends approval. This is the same, everything's the same as it's been since this fireworks has started. So the traffic pattern, everything is,
and the request
is the same. So do I have a motion?
Motion to approve, Barker.
Second, Barry.
Motion been made and second on the question. Anybody in the audience? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
New business B, 25 South Cass Avenue, dance studio special use. Board to consider an ordinance approving the following request from Expressions Dance Studio to allow the operation of a dance studio in the B1 Limited Business District. One, a special use permit, and 2, a development permit. I'd ask Community Development Director Ziegler to give more information.
Thank you, Mayor. The applicant requests a special use ordinance to operate a dance studio on the ground floor in the Central Business TIF District. The 6,000 square foot tenant space was previously a theater. The adjacent private parking lot is sufficient for the proposed use. Staff recommended as part of the Planning and Zoning Commission approval that the special use ordinance require sound mitigation as part of the build out, and those plans have been provided, that the parking lot be striped and maintained, and that commuter parking would no longer be permitted on site. The applicant received a positive recommendation from the Economic Development Committee and from Planning and Zoning Commission after working with staff and police on a parking and circulation plan that would be required to be followed as part of the ordinance. The dance studio customers also spoke in favor of the location at the public hearing. We included the applicant's materials as part of the agenda packet to show all of the background material that went into the presentation, which you probably also saw online. I think a couple of the dancers might also be here this evening, and Amber Alonzo is available for questions about her business and proposed plan if there are any questions.
Okay. Do I have a motion?
So move, Guzzo.
To approve as presented.
Second.
Motion made and second. On the question, I'll go to the trustees first.
Yeah, I did have a question. Is in this facility, if you were to go into that facility, do you have the ability to expand your programs as you grow?
So right now we have a current 4 studios running, studio spaces. So we would start with 5 studios with a limited schedule that we then can continue to grow and develop more classes during the day and in the evening as well. So it increase the studio space that we have as well as the time we'd be able to use all the rooms. So yes.
So you don't see yourself outgrowing this in a year or two?
No. Hopefully not, yeah.
Well, that's a good problem to have, right?
Yeah, that would be an awesome problem, but we're not prepared for that just yet. So we're hoping that we could stay in here for 5 to 10 years for sure. Mm-hmm.
Are you planning on having any special dance recitals and that kind of thing, like in the evenings or on the weekends? And
right now, when we do special performances, they're normally outside of the studio. But sometimes we might have different camp activities or things like that where some would be, but it would never be a mass amount of people coming to see a show. We always rent outside facilities for that.
Yeah, and it looks, I looked over the parking because I know that area very well, and it looks like there was a lot of planning that went into that to make sure that it was going to be the best fit for the planning issues, if there were any, with the parking and, you know, traffic and everything. So it looks, you can really tell that there was a lot of effort put in here by everybody, so.
Yeah, there was. Thank you.
Any other trustee questions?
And I think, Attorney, we've addressed the landlord with his commuter parking. I believe we've put that into the text amendment, correct?
Not into the ordinance.
To the ordinance
it will
itself.
Be put into the ordinance. It wasn't in the original draft of the ordinance, but it will. And the owner, I think, is here tonight and was here at planning and zoning, and that was communicated at that time, and it was understood by the owner that commuter parking will end when this occupancy starts.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Great.
Any other trustee? And then I'll open it up to the public. If anybody has something they'd like to say, now's the time. You told me to say that. Now's the time. Two of you can go up there.
Well, my name is Jill Jackson, and I'm a resident just 3 blocks south of here. And I'm reading a letter from another Westmont resident, and her name is Haley Chapman, and she lives on the 300 south block of Williams. And honestly, I don't know that I'll get through it without crying. She's out of town and wanted me to read it on her behalf. It says, Dear Village Board Members, my name is Haley Chapman, and I'm an 18-year resident of Westmont. My 14-year-old daughter and 13-year-old son have been dancing and learning at EDS for the past 5 years. For the past 2 years, I've driven my daughter out to Lyons, where her company classes have been held because of the lack of space in our current Westmont location. My son's classes had to be held at the Park District this year for the same reason. We are thrilled that this next year they'll both have the opportunity to dance in the EDS location in Westmont together. My husband and myself feel blessed that our children have had the opportunity to be taught by expert teachers that truly care for our children. Though EDS has 500 students, there is a warmth and special atmosphere of our small family. The kids all care about each other, and the older kids are taught and encouraged to be role models. I didn't even write it. Jeez. For the younger students, my daughter Macy attends Westmont High School and has had opportunities to substitute in tap classes with the younger students, and now she has the goal of teaching more in the future. Amber has always encouraged her to reach for her dreams and is a wonderful role model for all the students that can be successful at a young age, as long as they're willing to put the work in. Because we're a studio, we know each other, we take part in carpooling, and are very aware of the safety of the students. Up to this point, there are no teenage drivers taking themselves to dance. The parents drive. Our family has had the opportunity to meet and become close with families from many of the surrounding towns. These bonds are very strong and that we have made, and without EDS, we probably would not have met. This is not just a place where my children dance, but a most special place that has shown my children what dreams are made of. Please allow EDS to continue to touch the lives of students right here in Westmont. Westmont deserves a business that puts its young clients in a positive atmosphere where parents feel comfortable leaving them in the hands of a business that truly cares. Thank you for your time, Haley Chapman.
Very well said. Now, who's with you at the podium?
I have a copy.
She got a copy.
Thank you very much.
We didn't introduce your co-spokesperson.
This was my daughter, Kate Stiles, and she, before coming to the meeting, wanted to say a few words, but now might have changed her mind. Say anything or no?
She got on TV.
Mm-hmm. Well, I will say something. Again, I'm Jill Jackson, and, you know, we have been part of the studio since it opened six years ago? Mm-hmm. 6 years ago. I've got a five-year-old in the program. I've got a seven-year-old who dances there, and I also dance as an adult. And it's a great place. And to have it all in Westmont, instead of a little studio in Westmont, another studio in Lyons, another one in the Park District, to have everybody under one roof to really... Amber's tagline for the studio is where family and dance go hand in hand. To have everybody really be under one roof would really make that possible. So we hope that you pass. You accept. Yeah. Whatever you're going to do, just let her do it.
Right. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else from the audience would like to? You could come on up, state your name, and I guess your address, too, for the record.
Okay, I'm Heather Castle. I'm from 51 West End Avenue, and I come up here as a resident. My daughters have also danced at Expression for five of the last 6 years, and I'm also a business owner, and my husband is also a business owner in downtown Westmont. So, No Corner Sons Art Studio and Uncle John's Music, we are very proud of having the dance studio part of the downtown, and it has been great for our businesses too, because parents who come from other parts of Westmont and other surrounding areas will drop their children off at Expression, and the other child will come take a class at No Corner Sons, or will go get their saxophone repaired at Uncle John. So it's been really beneficial to have those people coming into Westmont and going to downtown and having that. And also, I want to mention too that besides the dance studio, the Alonzos have just been very supportive of the Westmont community, and all of the community events, the street fair, the Taste of Westmont, all of these things. And I think that it would be so great to just have them housed here in Westmont and continue their support of the community.
Thank you. Anybody who wants to address this needs to come to the podium and state your name and address. Okay.
My name's Tanya. I'm also a mother of a few dancers at Expressions and a little four-year-old who can't wait to get there, too. I just want to say basically what this lady just said before me is that not only is Amber a great owner and her parents are so involved and everybody else, it's been a really nice, tight community, but from the standpoint of being in Westmont and being in one space, as mothers, I don't think parking would be an issue because we love to carpool and not have to come as often, but also these rehearsals are long and these kids get really hungry, so I think it would just help your environment. And there's many times where we've been at Lyons and have to wait, and there's just not many places around there to get together, whereas if we were able to come here, even as moms, because we have grown close and found friends, we would be able to have somewhere to socialize and hang out. So I just think it'd be positive all around, and I was super excited that this was a possibility because that studio is small and tight, and there's nowhere for parents to hang out as much in that waiting room, so it'd be nice to have a nice new space for everybody.
All right.
Anyway, thank you.
Come on up to the podium.
My name is Sarah Cunningham. I'm a Westmont resident, and also my daughter and myself dance at the studio, and we have for the past 6 years. As a resident, I don't understand why you cannot approve it 100% to keep the dance studio in the town. It is a successful business to bring to our town and grow and help to develop our town and get it back to its greatness. We've seen restaurants come and go. We've seen nail salons come and go. We've seen cleaners come and go. We need businesses that are going to stay, such as Uncle John's, and those businesses that have been around forever. This studio is going to need a home to stay, and this is where we need it to stay, is here in Westmont. The parents carpool, the parents will obey the laws. I have been down Cass Avenue where I have seen other businesses, such as the restaurants, just stop dead in the street and let people out in the middle of Cass Avenue. It's an issue at all of the businesses. It's not going to be at the dance studio. We are not going to let our kids out in the middle of Cass Avenue and risk their lives. We are going to pull in and we are going to do as we are told, and we are going to follow the regulations exactly like we have at this place. And I think this new space is going to be amazing to help grow the business, the self-esteem of young ladies, and bring extra dollar signs to the town of Westmont. And I can't say enough about Expressions, and it needs to stay. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else? I do add a couple of comments that I know that this is the second location, and I think fortunately the first one didn't work out. This is a much better location for every aspect of your business. And I do think our staff has been very motivated to work with you, trying to assist you in finding a place to stay in Westmont. So I think we've done everything we can, because you are a good partner to have in this community. We want you to stay. So I think, and I know our staff has done that. Larry Forsberg and Jill worked with you trying to find. I'm glad this is, you're staying on the right side of the tracks. No, you're still downtown, so of course I live on that side. But any other comments from trustees, anybody else? Then I'd ask for we had a motion to approve as presented. I ask for a roll call, please.
Trustee Guzzo?
Yes.
Trustee Barker?
Yes.
Trustee Little?
Absolutely yes.
Trustee Barry?
Yes.
Well, you just was approved by everyone. And what's the date for an opening?
Oh, we're hoping for September.
You can come up to the mic real quick.
September 1st.
Oh, good.
Yes, right after the holiday. Yes.
Very good.
9th, something like that. Yeah.
Good.
We're ready to get started.
And
thank you.
And we want to make sure we get a ribbon cutting from Larry
Absolutely.
Forsberg, and we'll make sure we
Absolutely.
Get everybody there.
Great.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. Everyone, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks for doing your homework.
All right, we'll move on to new business D. Before we move on, you're welcome to stay, but if you want to get up and go out, now may be the time. Yeah. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Go to the street fair.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.
Bye, Aaron.
Bye.
Bye.
And now we'll move on to new business to you, a tenant text amendment. Board to consider ordinance approving a text amendment to the zoning code to allow administrative approval of attendance in certain instances. I'd ask Community Development Director Ziegler to explain.
Thank you, Mayor. Staff recommends administrative approval of certain businesses in the B1 and B2 districts that would typically require special uses if they are less than 1,000 square feet. The intention is to be more efficient, be small business friendly, and save time and money. The Planning and Zoning Commission made a unanimous positive recommendation after discussing concerns such as not having a public notice or hearing and encouraging too many service uses. The small size for administrative approval should not allow a majority of service uses by right. In addition, in the B1 district, we also require a development permit for new businesses, so the board would still have the ability to review each new business in each instance. So,
do I have a motion to approve?
Motion to approve, Barry.
Second, Little.
On the question, any of the trustees, anybody?
I just know that Trustee Barry. Addington's been adamant about this for a long time, about trying to slimline this process, and I'm glad to see that we're moving forward on it.
And on one hand, this takes away the public hearing process for these small businesses, but history has shown, I think, over the years that these, because of the size, there really hasn't been an impact on surrounding properties. No one has shown up for these public hearings,
right?
And there's still the development permit process that Jill mentioned, where if there was a concerned resident, they'd have the opportunity to come speak.
Right. And typically, you're going to see those smaller-sized businesses that are less than 1,000 square feet in the downtown where you still require the development permit. And we haven't had any concerns with those small ones that have opened so far.
Any additional questions? Anybody in the audience? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Motion passes. We'll move on to new business E, text amendment, not-for-profit solicitation. Board to did I miss one?
Yeah, we've got the antenna text amendment.
D.
Oh, D. All right. There it is. D. We'll attend. Antenna text amendment. Board to consider ordinance approving a text amendment to the zoning code to allow administrative approval of antennas in certain instances. Again, I ask Community Development Director Ziegler to comment.
Thank you. Telecommunications antennas on existing towers and previously approved structures are typically very straightforward requests with consistent approvals. To facilitate a more efficient process, we're recommending administrative approvals in certain instances. If the antennas are located on existing telecommunications equipment with approved structural calculations by a structural engineer and they're painted to match the structure. Planning and Zoning Commission discussed the lack of public comment for these proposals and that structural loads would still be reviewed and improved by an engineer. Planning and Zoning Commission made a unanimous positive recommendation and an update was provided last week or 2 weeks ago to Community Development Committee.
Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve, Barker.
Second, Guzzo.
On the question.
Yeah, I did have a question. You know, we've had this come up a couple of times with the antennas on power poles and things like that. Does that old technology that's there that's being replaced with new technology, does that get removed or they just add to it? You know, we used to do a thing in the church called abandon in place because right. It was cheaper.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes they leave it up and sometimes they take it down. The process was more straightforward if they could remove it, but if they're still using them, they typically leave them up. In that instance, we'd still, you know, be reviewing the structural calculations to make sure that the equipment is solid enough to handle.
Would we have the ability to make them take down the obsolete stuff? I mean,
for example, if it was our property, like a tower or something,
Yes. Then
we would require that, but sometimes they're on a building or
right. It
would, you know, sort of up to the property owner.
Right, like the Hilton roof, and then we have a cell tower on 63rd Street.
How about like the ComEd, you know, they added new equipment there because their old equipment didn't function or didn't work the way it should. Does that old equipment get abandoned or removed? It's kind of the same.
Yeah, I don't know what they did.
I don't know that qualifies as an antenna up on a
some kind
tower
of signal
structure.
Repeater.
Yeah. You're talking about the North Cass one, right?
Yes.
That one would still require special use because it was a new pole that was added.
Right. Yeah.
So in this instance, it would just be adding to an existing structure.
My idea is that, you know, it just doesn't become a junkyard
yeah. On
top of the water tower,
on
top of the buildings or whatever.
Sure.
So.
And as Manager May said, we have a little bit more control when it's village-owned, so yeah. We do work with them on instances like
that. And we've
that.
Got license agreements with those users of the water tower, and I'm quite positive the license agreements require removal of unused equipment.
Okay. Good. Thank you.
And the real issue is, right now, the village code limits the number of antennas to 3 on any one structure, so we're getting all these variance requests for more than 3, and they're routinely granted.
Right.
So why not streamline the process and eliminate the maximum number of 3.
Mm-hmm. Any additional questions? Anybody in the audience? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Johannik.
Yes.
Guzzo, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I go by both.
I see Johannik and there comes out of my mouth. Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Motion passes. Well, now we'll move on to new business E.
There you go.
Text amendment, not-for-profit solicitation. Board to consider an ordinance restricting not-for-profit organizations to solicit contributions at intersections to 1 time per year. I'd ask Manager May to explain.
Mayor, this was an item that was also covered at the administration committee, but we already have a policy in place that that regulates who can apply for such permits to do these solicitations in the street. It is very well spelled out that what types of organizations, and then tying it to, it has to be like a national event, not just I want to do it this weekend. And by practice, we've been limiting organizations to one time per year already for the same event, and this is just cleaning up the language that codifies that restriction that we've already been practicing.
And if you go back to traditional, the KCs, the Lions, the Kiwanis always did one big event a year, and we always had to approve that when they were in town. Kiwanis is no longer here. Do I have a motion to approve?
Motion to approve, Barry.
Second, Little.
On the question. Now, if there was, my question would be, if there was a special situation, could we then grant a second?
Yes, they can come to the village board and ask permission for more than one time.
Okay. Okay. Any additional questions? Anybody? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
We move on to miscellaneous. Before I move on, and I always have done this since we started at 6, I don't know if you had anything, the couple that you wanted to, you missed open forum, if there's anything you'd like to, if you do, come up to the, just come. No, I saw you here, and that I tried to recognize somebody when you came in after open forum. So I need you to state your name.
I'm Margaret Rossi. I'm a resident of Westmont. I live over on Washington right here. I've lived here about 2 years, and I guess I came today to kind of get a better understanding of like what we can do to build the downtown area. I love Westmont. I grew up in Darien. My grandparents lived in Westmont, and it's just, sometimes it just feels like it could be like Downers Grove or LaGrange, where it has a very vibrant like feel to the city. And I know we're getting better, but it just feel like, I didn't want to say it when they were here, but you know, it seems like we have 2 dance studios, 4 dentists, a lot of repeated, 2 ice cream places. It just seems repeated and a little not different. It needs more variety. And I guess I'm just curious how I could get involved in, like, with
you see that gentleman in the back there? Larry Forsberg is not only the chamber director, but he's our economic development director, and he loves when he hears somebody like yourself who's excited about our downtown. He'll get you involved.
Okay. And I felt bad. I didn't want to disclose, you know, all the hard work that's been going on for the dance studio, but I have heard just, like, rumors of breweries coming into the downtown area, and as a younger person myself and people that I know that live in the city, and it would be so close to a downtown area, I knew it would be something desirable for people to look into.
Yeah, and I think from the village's standpoint, we've created a TIF district to provide that incentive for businesses to come in for the downtown area, as well as the South 63rd Street. And when we did it on 63rd, it drew Mariano's into town. Without it, we wouldn't have had them. So we're looking for something like that in downtown so we could jumpstart everything and get the whole downtown vibrant again.
And that's great. Are you talking about Urban Legend? Or?
They could be one of them. There could be others. And I think Larry has, if not 5 or 6 discussions almost every week with somebody looking to either relocate in another area, Westmont, to downtown, or somebody outside the community to come downtown. So we are actively, we're with you,
okay,
with your feeling.
No, and I'm just here just to kind of learn. You knew I was a...
You're welcome to come anytime. Yep, you're welcome to come anytime.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
And, you know, one of the major items that's going on is going on this evening. You know, we're really seeing the difference in the people coming to downtown, and I think that that's going to be noticed by developers and so forth. So I think we're getting closer all the time. We all feel that way. I know we feel like we're getting closer all the time. So, but we'd love to have you here. So, thank you.
And again, thank you. Miscellaneous. Anybody have any miscellaneous items they'd like to discuss? Trustee Barry.
I do. As long as we're talking downtown. Manager May, I know when you wore a different hat, we talked about the paving of Cass Avenue, and it seemed like that last 20 yards or something between the railroad tracks and where they stopped the last time was left off. And it's really bad. It's splitting, and it almost appears that we're doing Burlington and we're not going to do that section now. Is that still not going to be done again?
I don't actually know the limits of where the paving is. Often if we were doing Burlington and not doing Cass Avenue itself, the north leg of Cass Avenue up to the railroad, that would be routine and normal to just start at like the stop bar at Burlington Avenue and go down, and that has to do with traffic signal equipment too. What I don't know is if the Cass Avenue is part of our second project this year or not, and I will find out because by tomorrow and let you know. I just don't know tonight.
I personally have disappointment if I see, you know, that we patched up to where it was really bad last time, and then now we're back there a summer later, and we come up, you know, within 10 feet of it, and we leave, you know, one of our main arteries there that's kind of splitting, just for those, you're familiar with where I'm talking, right?
Yeah, I mean, you're talking about right in the middle of the intersection, and the previous work you were talking about was the railroad expansion, and we got up close to the intersection at Burlington, and now, like you said, we're at Burlington and stopping.
And even there, when we came down Cass, we kind of stopped at the bus stop. We left that from the railroad to like the bus stop, we left unrepaired, and so that's where that it's the road's literally splitting in half. There,
yeah. You know. I recognize the existing condition. I don't remember that stopping that way before, but I'll have a better answer for you tomorrow.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Any other miscellaneous? Seeing none, I'd entertain a motion to adjourn to closed session to discuss matters that are permitted by law and act upon. The executive session will be to discuss the purchase of real estate by the village for a public purpose, and two, the setting of a price for the sale of real estate owned by the village. Do I have a motion to adjourn the executive session?
Motion, Barry.
Second, Guzzo.
Motion made, second. Roll call, please.
Trustee Barry.
Yes.
Trustee Little.
Yes.
Trustee Guzzo.
Yes.
Trustee Barker.
Yes.
Okay, this part of the meeting is going to be adjourned. There will not be any further business after the executive session. So again, thank you for coming. This part is adjourned. Thank you.